just said. Take a look at what happened.
Donald Trump called on Americans to stand united after he was injured in an assassination attempt. A shocking incident. In a statement on his Truth social network, he added that Americans should not allow evil to win. The Republican added that it was God alone who prevented the unthinkable from happening and that he would fear not. The 78-year-old former president was hit in the ear at a campaign rally in Butler, Pennsylvania, while the shooter and the bystander were killed and two spectators critically injured in the worst act of U.S. political violence in decades. The gunman has been identified as 20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crooks of Bethel Park, Pennsylvania, about an hour's drive from the rally site, according to an FBI statement early Sunday. His motive remains unknown. U.S. President Joe Biden was getting a fresh briefing later Sunday at the White House on the assassination bid against his rival in November's 10th election. The 81-year-old Democrat has called the attack sick and spoke to Trump afterwards. He also cut short a weekend at his vacation home and flew back to Washington to deal with the crisis.
There's no place in America for this kind of violence. It's sick. It's sick. It's one of the reasons why we have to unite this country. We cannot allow for this to be happening. We cannot be like this. We cannot condone this. And I want to thank the Secret
Service. World leaders have condemned the attack, with the Kremlin on Sunday morning saying there was no place for violence in politics. Over 10,000 Rwandans cast their votes at the Rwanda High Commission in Kampala as Rwanda goes to the polls today. By 7 a.m., several Rwandans had started arriving at the High Commission to vote for their president and members of parliament. Rwanda High Commissioner to Uganda, Joseph Rutabana, who was also the election coordinator, took his oath, followed by the election assessors, who were all donning white.
Solemnly swear to Rwanda that I will remain loyal to the Republic of Rwanda.
Shortly after casting his vote, Rutabana noted all results would be tallied and sent to the National Electoral Commission last night. During a press conference at the Rwandan High Commission, Rutabana had noted that there would be an arrangement for those who were not registered to also take part.
It will be done electronically. There is a good system which has been established by the Electoral Commission. So when we finish counting manually, we will feed the results into the system and they will get it immediately. So in general, there is no main challenge.
President Paul Kagame, the Rwandan Patriotic Front, is in the race with two other contenders. These are Frank Habineza of the Democratic Green Party and Philippe Mpayimana, an independent. The presidential and parliamentary elections started yesterday and will end tomorrow. President Yoweri Museveni has rallied leaders to be champions of wealth creation in their communities.
Really, the message I want to insist is the issue of wealth creation in the homes. I really don't know how we shall continue to talk about this endlessly. And people just running around, wasting time, talking nonsense. And we just politely try to massage them, but doing nothing.
He made the remarks during the closing ceremony of the 7-day retreat at the National Leadership Institute in Chankwanzi District on Friday. Museveni noted that the NRM's manifestos all revolve around how to change a traditional society into a modern one, and all the funds sent to the parishes are geared towards helping people enter the money economy.
You can see these are potentially very rich people, but they are still underutilizing the land by the free-range method. We are now trying to move them free-range to the Nyakana model, where you don't do free-range. You do intensive farming. If they do that, there will be Uganda will totally change. There will be billionaires.
Lucinda Chobe, the cabinet secretary, thanked the president for the support he has rendered to the cabinet to execute their work to the best of their abilities.
First and foremost, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to you, Your Excellency Mzee, for your support, guidance, and presence at this retreat. This is invaluable and we are inspired by your dedication to serving our great nation.
She noted that they have engaged in several discussions during the retreat and crafted strategic plans that will guide the nation moving forward.